gorgeous.
Fine.
Peanut butter. Now he want peanut butter. He like caramel.
Piece of man.
6 feet tall.
Channel. It is Jay Kareen and
Gina Janine,
and we back with another story time.
Oh yeah,
they coming and coming.
Liking these.
They coming and coming. Mm-hmm. All right, this is a story of Bunny and Connie. You know, it's Bunny and Clyde, but it's Bunny and Connie on this
yes.
story. So on this particular story, baby, back in high school, and I don't even know why we were doing it because we didn't have a reason to do it, but for some reason we used to go in these stores and put our hands on these people's stuff, and we would leave with our hand for it. Okay.
Yes.
So I thought
five finger discount.
So after getting away with it so many times, I had named myself a booster. Okay. So if you attended the Kappa Beach party, you would come to me and I would get you your swimsuit, your sunglasses, your accessories,
kids clothes.
You name it, I had it. So this one particular time, we went to a mall here in Houston.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided to put our hands on these people's stuff.
But wait, this is gonna take you way back though. The name of the store?
Mervyn's,
California.
Yes.
At that.
Yes.
Because I think that chain of stores only lasted for like 5 years.
Yep, it did. So we in Mervyn's, and we, you know, went in, that wasn't our first time in Mervyn's. We went in, did what we had to do, and upon leaving, I think, were you in front of me?
I was in front, because I'm like, we can't walk out together. I go first, then you come after me.
Okay, so she went first.
Even though we was in the store stealing together.
we had to split up. And this the kicker right here. We didn't even drive to the mall. We got dropped off at the mall.
Because okay. were you 13 or 14?
I don't remember, but our dumb ass got dropped off, okay?
Yeah, we couldn't drive. We were like 14 years old at the time.
So when she walked out the store, I walked out behind her. So I turn around, it's this gorgeous,
fine.
Peanut butter. Now he wanted peanut butter. He like caramel.
Piece of man.
6 feet tall.
No, security suit. He in regular clothes. Mm-hmm. I think he might have had a Nike jump off on or something like
yes,
that.
I think he did.
And he was like, hey, can I talk to you? He said, and can you call your friend back? I want to holler at her. So I'm thinking, oh, okay. So
this fine man want to talk to a 14-year-old.
So I called her back. Baby, that man turned around, had two sets of handcuffs in each pocket.
It sure did.
I could have just died.
And y'all, I had made it out the store. I'm like, out the store, like a couple hundred feet out the store. And he called back, and I'm like, who is this fine man? And he looked kind of young, like maybe 19, 20.
Wave some point.
Yeah, so I walked back, stupid.
And so as he turns around, we're looking at these handcuffs. And I thought my life had ended, okay? Because that was my first run-in with the police. I thought everything was over.
Same.
And I wasn't even scared that much of the police. I was more scared of Crazy Gwen, what she was going to do to me when she got her hands on me. So he was like, okay, y'all come with me, whatever. So we went into this office. They separated us at this point.
They did.
So I'm looking at what they're doing. They are calculating everything as they taking it off of us. So the higher the amount of stuff that you've taken, the bigger the citation or the charge or whatever the case may be. So I started putting the stuff on me. I had headbands on my head. I had sunglasses here, there. So, cause they didn't like frisk us. They didn't search our person. So I had stuff hidden everywhere. So they were like, I thought they were gonna allow us to call our parents so that we can, you know, go to the house.
Yeah.
But they was like, nope, y'all going to juvenile.
Yeah.
I'm like, juvenile, so yeah.
I fell out crying.
Yeah, I'm crying. And again, we are separated, so now we by ourselves. So the cop car came. I don't even remember seeing you even after that.
Well, they had me call Angie. I think I called Angie. I don't think I called
Well, Angie was waiting outside
for
us.
She
was supposed to pick us up.
Right.
So you called Angie, and I didn't have to call my mom until I actually got to the juvenile facility. So, and it was in Richmond, so we drove far. It seemed like a never-ending ride.
Yes.
So we get to the juvenile facility.
Did they handcuff you?
No.
They never handcuffed me. I could have took off running like Sha'Carri Richardson, but I was, you know,
baby,
fat and slow. Still is.
At that time, the way our weight was set up, we wasn't gonna make it a few feet, okay? Right. All right, so we get to the juvenile facility, and through the glass, I can see her, but of course, I can't talk to her. And they made me call my mom. My brother answered the phone. He's like, girl, you play too much. I'm telling him, I'm in juvenile. I need to talk to mama. You play too much. Hang up in my face.
Because they know she a jokester. So she jokes.
I joke all the time. I play all the time. So it was like the little boy that cried wolf, honey.
Yeah.
So after that, I don't remember what happened.
I had called my aunt because she was outside the mall waiting on us. So I had called her because I was like, my aunt's here. Like, y'all could just tell my aunt, like we can just go home with her. So I wound up calling her, and I'm like, well, they're taking us to jail. And because I don't remember if I called my mom. I think when I called my aunt from the actual store, she told my mom because she was living with us at the time. And then my mom and my stepdad had showed up to the juvenile facility. I don't remember. I could have called them. I don't remember. This was just so many years ago, like 20 plus years
right.
ago.
So after that, they did frisk me there. They frisked me at the facility. Mm-hmm. However, I still had them headbands and sunglasses that I stuck on top of my head at Mervyn's. I still had that, and they counted that as my merchandise. They never said, you know, this is part of the items that were stolen or anything.
And so with me, they frisked me too, but I wasn't as smart as her trying to put stuff on my body. I had like boots, bras, leggings, t-shirts. That's why I couldn't put that stuff on my body. So when they frisked me, they literally took my hair down. Mm-hmm. I had my hair in a little ponytail. When my mom picked me up, my hair was all over my head. My mom was like, did they hurt you? Did they beat you up? My mom was more concerned with the way I looked than what had actually happened.
My mama was looking at me through that glass saying, as soon as you get out of here, I'm gonna kick your butt. That's how she was looking at me. So after that.
Then they said we couldn't be friends anymore.
Yeah, they did. And that hurt my little feelings.
They're like, you guys cannot go to lunch together at school. You cannot call each other. You can't talk in the hallways. You guys are banned from being friends.
Mm-hmm. And they did say that. And I think that
the next day,
we was talking to each other. I think I wrote her a letter too. And I tried to give it to somebody. I'm like, get this to Gina when you in class with them. Well, my mama thought that, you know, she wasn't naive to the fact that, you know, I was partially to blame for my actions, but she tried to switch schools. She tried to switch me schools, so she had me transferred out of Elkins to this charter school that was 10 times worse than Elkins, okay?
Oh my goodness.
So after that, we were on probation.
Yeah, for how long? How long was our probation?
I want to say 9 months.
And we had to do community. We never did our community service together.
No.
They must have
separated us somehow.
Because mine was like every Saturday, or was it?
Mine was too.
So how did they separate us? Mm.
But we did community service.
Yeah.
And this is where I think I grew addicted to liking Bad Boys, because it was some boys.
Oh,
it was
God.
Some boys also at the juvenile facility, and they made us do stuff that I was not used to, y'all.
Yeah, they did.
Manual labor. I'm talking about putting my, and I used to wear eagle nails, you know, the nails, they got the hook, and they like this long. That's how I used to wear my nails.
She did.
So we used to have to go and plant the inmates' food in the garden.
Wash their underwear.
They used to do a white sock check on the cell where we would have to clean the cell, and then the sergeant would come behind us and kind of use a white sock to make sure no dirt ended up on the sock.
Dang.
So it was just awful. You know, I was not used to all in the heat and all, baby, no. I wasn't used to all that. So I think we did that for 9 months, but they also—
Did y'all have to do push-ups and jog?
Push-up and jog. And you know—
In the dirt.
You know, we was fluffy girls.
We sure
was. We wasn't used to that.
And we from the suburbs, y'all, so.
And I used to skip PE class. Because I don't do exercise.
Isn't it crazy?
Now I exercise daily. But that was, and then they also, let me not speak.
We had to pay a fee. There was some type of fee.
We had to pay
also.
A fee. We had to pay probation fees. And they also made us take a class that made us better criminals. Can you believe that?
Oh my goodness.
Ooh, Lord, we got stories for days, honey.
And you know what, Miss Thea? I wish y'all would have gotten to meet her, but I remember like my second day of doing my community service, they made us do push-ups and sit-ups in the dirt. And when my mom picked me up, she was like, why are you so dirty? Why are you? I was like, Mom, they made us do push-ups, sit-ups in the dirt. She felt so bad that day she bought me concert tickets to see the Hot Boys because she just felt so bad for me. After she had to pay hundreds of dollars in, not restitution, whatever the fees.
Yeah, that's what
I'm on probation. I'm going to, and this woman is just so like that sweet to mm-hmm. where nobody could touch her baby, not even a lot.
Total opposite. Gwen was like, that's what you get. You break the law, you pay the consequences. They should do more than, I should do more than that, than you, more to you than that. Gwen, total opposite, honey.
Oh,
we got stories for days, y'all.
We do.
Days.
And you know what was so crazy? I started just stealing even more sneakier.
Because they made us take that class. Yeah. That made us better criminals. They used to tell us where they hid, like if they didn't have, you know, they have the
certain kind of
sensors on it,
yeah.
How they could do the electronic sensors in the tag,
yeah.
How you could deactivate them.
Mm-hmm.
They took us through a class that made us even better.
Yeah.
Because it didn't stop there, y'all.
It didn't. It got worse.
It got worse.
It got to a point to where I was like kind of scared. I'm like, I'm everywhere I go, I'm stealing. Like I'm stealing.
She turned
something.
Into a klepto.
Yeah.
I did.
And my mom, okay, and then my sister, she was younger than us. She started stealing also. And my mom would go in, my sister's closet and be like,
Where'd you get this from?
Where'd you buy this? And she was like, oh, one of my friends let me borrow it. She was like, oh, okay, well, that's cute. My mom was very naive.
Mine, no. Mm-mm, mine wasn't. And she's still not to this day, honey. In the wheelchair and all, I'd be scared of that lady. I'd be like, I'm not gonna mess with her. She's crazy.
Uh-huh.
Lord, can y'all lock her up? That's what I wanted to say. She's gonna beat me. Y'all, but let's go back to this stuff when she said boots. Y'all, we had these white patent leather go-go boots like we was gonna be a majorette or something.
Yes.
Terrible. I had a powder blue suit,
bell-bottom suit.
Girl.
Did you ever wear yours? I never wore mine.
I wore mine, baby. Don't play with me.
Oh, I wish we could find pictures of that.
No.
Y'all, and the suit, the material of the suit, I remember it was like kind of ribbed, but it was like super thick and stretchy. Yeah, we looked like we were straight from like 1972. Don't know where we was going. We were 14
Don't
years
fight.
Old. Exactly.
But we got a story for days. So if you like these story times, please comment below and tell us what you want to hear. What you want to hear?
We got
a ton of them, baby. Mm-hmm. A ton. But until next time, I'm checking out. J. Kareem.
Jim Janine.
Love you guys.
Bye.